left, right and center. I'm Nidhi Razdan. On the show this Friday night, as one of the country's most prominent Muslim leaders, the Shahi Imam of the Jama Masjid in Delhi, announces that he's backing the Congress. Is this communal politics by the Congress party, or are these double standards by the BJP, which has strongly objected? And as The Economist writes a stinging piece on why Narendra Modi should not be India's Prime Minister, should India even care what foreign publications say? Does this have any impact on perceptions and indeed the election campaign? But first, the Shahi Imam of the Jama Masjid, Syed Ahmed Bukhari, today declared his support to the Congress, saying that it will strengthen secularism while calling communalism a bigger threat to the country than corruption. Bukhari appealed to Muslims to support the Congress party and to ensure that secular votes are not divided. That comes just days after his meeting with Sonia Gandhi that sparked off a huge row. While the BJP has called this a desperate move by the Congress and complained to the Election Commission, Sonia Gandhi today lashed out at Narendra Modi, asking whether someone who lies should be Prime Minister.
मैं आज लोकसभा इंतखाबात 2014 के लिए कांग्रेस की हिमायत का ऐलान करता हूं। करप्शन से ज्यादा फिरकापरस्ती इस मुल्क में मुद्दा है। फिरकापरस्ती से मुल्क टूटा करते हैं, करप्शन से नहीं।
The Shahi Imam of the Jama Masjid endorsing the Congress and the TMC days after his meeting with Sonia Gandhi created controversy. Over the past four decades, there have been several occasions where leaders like Indira Gandhi in 1980, Atal Bihari Vajpayee in 99, and Mulayam Singh Yadav in 2012 had met the Shahi Imam asking for his support. But many political watchers believe the Shahi Imam does not have that kind of influence anymore.
Bukhari sahab ne jo statement diya hai unke behalf par, Congress ke behalf par, wo pure maton ka dhruvikaran ka bahut hi sharmnak prayas hai. चुनाव आयोग को इसका संज्ञान लेना चाहिए।
But stung by Narendra Modi's attack, accusing her of resorting to rabid communalism, Sonia Gandhi hit back at a rally today, asking whether someone who lies was fit for the PM's post.
भारत जैसे महान देश का प्रधानमंत्री बनना इस बात से तय होगा कि कौन ज्यादा ऊंची सीधी बातें कर सकता है, कौन ज्यादा झूठ बोल सकता है।
In a campaign already so polarized over the issue of secularism, this piece by The Economist on Narendra Modi has created another storm. The news magazine has written, Modi made speeches early in his career that shamelessly whipped up Hindus against Muslims. One reason why the inquiries into the riots were inconclusive is that a great deal of evidence was lost or willfully destroyed. Unlike other BJP leaders, Mr. Modi has refused to wear a Muslim skullcap and failed to condemn riots in Uttar Pradesh in 2013 when most of the victims were Muslims. If Mr. Modi were to explain his role in the violence and show genuine remorse, we would consider backing him, but he never has. For now, he should be judged on his record, which is that of a man who is still associated with sectarian hatred. India deserves better.
हर मैगजीन हर अखबार अपने आर्टिकल लिखने के लिए स्वतंत्र है, लेकिन देश की जमीन की सच्चाई जो है वो आज चीख चीख कर बोल रही है कि देश सुशासन की तरफ बढ़ रहा है, देश मोदी राज की तरफ बढ़ रहा है और देश में कांग्रेस देश कांग्रेस के कुशासन से मुक्ति चाहता है।
The fight over secularism is clearly set to get more bitter. With Tanima Biswas and Siddharth Pandey, Vijay Kumar for NDTV.
So is the Congress party guilty of playing communal politics, or is the BJP's criticism unfair? Does it reek of double standards? Is everyone in a sense playing polarizing politics in this election campaign? We first have Shahid Siddiqui here in the studio with us. What do you make of the Imam Bukhari's decision to endorse the Congress party? Will it make any difference to the Congress electorally?
It won't make any difference. Basically, what Congress seems to be desperate. And Imam was also desperate to find some party which it could endorse. So it's a union of desperados who have come together to really in a situation where both are losing. And Imam Bukhari बेसिकली बीजेपी कांग्रेस वॉज वरीड अबाउट दिल्ली एंड आम आदमी पार्टी टेकिंग अ चंक ऑफ द मुस्लिम वोट बिकॉज मुस्लिम वर नाउ मूविंग मोर टूवर्ड्स आम आदमी पार्टी एंड दे वर टेरिफाइड दैट इफ द मुस्लिम वोट इज डिवाइडेड देन दे आर गोइंग टू लूज ऑल द 7 सीट्स सो इट्स मोर फॉर दिल्ली बट इन दिल्ली इमाम हैज नो इन्फ्लुएंस इन जामा मस्जिद ही हैज नो इन्फ्लुएंस ही हैज नॉट बीन एबल टू गेट अ सिंगल पर्सन इलेक्टेड एवर ही हैज बीन ट्राइंग टू स्टॉप शोएब इकबाल फॉर लास्ट 20 ईयर्स बट ही हैज फेल्ड टू डू दैट शोएब इकबाल हैज वन election after election in spite of Imam's opposition. So in Delhi, there will be no influence and in, of course, all India, there is hardly any influence.
But isn't it also true that, you know, in the past, there are big political leaders, including apparently Mr. Vajpayee, who did look at an endorsement from him. And therefore, was there a time, and Mulayam Singh Yadav and Indira Gandhi and so on. So was there a time where he did wield a certain influence? And is it today... is it fair to say that clerics today do not wield that kind of influence over the Muslim community as it's called, the way they once did?
That was his father, yeah. Abdullah Bukhari. Yeah. But even he had lost the credibility because sitting there in Jama Masjid, he should leave Jama Masjid and come into politics directly and become a political leader. And then he has the right to change parties, do whatever he wants and make a statement and support or oppose anybody. But sitting there and using the pulpit of Jama Masjid for his politics and for changing his line and for supporting BJP one day and Congress one day and some other party the third day, then he has lost credibility among the Muslims. He has lost credibility politically and he is of no... And that's why Mulayam Singh didn't bother about him when he went to him. He went to Mayawati. In last 1 month, he has gone to every party. He went to Mayawati. He tried to meet Mayawati. Mayawati refused to meet him. He wanted to endorse BSP. They didn't want his endorsement. He went to Mamata Banerjee. Mamata Banerjee didn't give him much, you know, lift. And now, because Congress has nobody, everybody is moving away from Congress. So now, he is the last effort of Sonia Gandhi to get the Muslim vote and block, but getting this vote in Muslim vote and block, it will lead to consolidation of Hindu votes. In fact, Sonia Gandhi has offered
BJP. You're saying it's going to help the BJP.
Help BJP. She has offered Hindu vote on a platter to the BJP by playing this kind of politics. Because Muslim vote, whatever had to come to Congress, will come to Congress. Not because of Bukhari, but because of the fear of the BJP. It will not come because of Bukhari. But Hindu vote will get more consolidated behind BJP than it would have otherwise.
Do you though see it as Modi called it and as the BJP called it, you know, communalism by the Congress? Is that what this is? Because in this election, you see that these words have also got redefined. Secularism has become a bad word. It's not actually meant to be that. So is this communal politics by the Congress party in your view?
Unfortunately, all parties have played communal politics in the name of secularism. Secularism has always been used to get Muslim votes. Secularism has not been for India. It has always been to get Muslim votes. So when you talk of secularism, what you mean is that, look, either you vote for us or India will become Hindu Rashtra. Either you vote for us or you will become second-class citizens. So they talk of secularism when they see a Muslim crowd before them. It's Congress, it's Samajwadi Party, it's RJD, it's the left. Unfortunately, left also had played that kind of game. So as a result, secularism has lost its real meaning and why India needs secularism to be a modern state, not because of minorities, not because there are 15 crores or 20 crore Muslims in India. And that has been lost. And responsibility goes not to BJP, but to these secular parties, because BJP always played its Hindu card. BJP has been playing on the fears of Hindus, but these secular parties have been playing on the fears of the minorities. And
but then everyone
used the secular mask.
In that sense, then Amir Raza Hussain also joins us tonight. Amir Raza Hussain, in a sense, then based on what Shahid Siddiqui is saying, it seems that both the BJP and the Congress are playing on the sentiments of one religion or the other. How different then are they in this election campaign? If today you have Sonia Gandhi talking about not dividing the secular vote and meeting Imam Bukhari, you have now Mr. Modi talking about things like cow slaughter on the other hand, you know, and that, you know, appeals to a certain sentiment among Hindus. Are they very different?
No, not at all. You see, Sonia Gandhi has started appealing to the secular vote in desperation right now. But Modi has been playing communal politics right from the start. You see, it's a very well thought out policy where till 3 months before the election, Modi has talked about hum paanch, hamare pachis. He has talked about the puppy, the burqa of secularism. He's talked about all kinds of things which would appeal to his core vote bank. Now, the other thing is that Modi suddenly started hawking his Gujarat example and his Gujarat achievement, whereas the secondary parties supporting him, that's the Vishwa Hindu Parishad, then etc., 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 have been playing up the Hindu communal card. So Modi has the best of both. He has this.
You don't see it as a communal card by the Congress when they're asking for or what the BJP says is asking for
that.
Votes. Yeah,
I'm coming to that, Nidhi.
Yeah.
No, please. I'm coming to that. Congress. So here is BJP playing a communal card. Now here is the Congress also. It's not Sonia Gandhi today who started playing the communal card. If you remember, before the elections, just before the elections were declared, you would have seen in all the national dailies full page advertisements by the Minister of Minority Affairs saying how much money has been allocated to minorities and how much money has been allocated to Muslim interests. Now what happens? None of that money is reaching, or maybe even 1% of that money reaches the minority community. All this hoopla goes to alienate the minority community from the majority community. Suddenly the majority community says, oh my God, so much is being given to them, so much is being done for them, why are we being left out of this? The Muslims get alienated.
So you're saying,
they don't get a share of the pie.
Ahmed Raza Hussain, you're saying both parties then are guilty of cynical politics in their own way. Each is doing it in its own way, but they're doing it.
They are doing it with a flourish. They are doing it with banners and flags waving. They are doing it with trumpets blaring. And not them. Everybody is doing it.
Okay, let me take this to Abhishek Singhvi.
Let
me just take this to Abhishek Singhvi of the Congress Party. Dr. Singhvi, is this communalism or is this secularism? The fact that Sonia Gandhi has this meeting with Imam Bukhari, he makes this endorsement of the Congress Party. Is this, in the garb of secularism, actually communalism, as the BJP says? Because it is a very divisive strategy in one sense.
Nidhi, I know the advantage of not being aligned with anybody is to use a battering ram and say, "Is the hamam mein sab nange hain," and that's something which gets you a lot of claps, and it's also a very evocative phrase. It may well be true, but the narrow question you're asking is, Sonia Gandhi meeting a delegation led by Imam Bukhari, does it amount to communalism? That's the answer is an emphatic no. Now, to that there are two points. How do you look at secularism? In a poor country, yes, affirmative action specifically for minority, targeted and honestly stated to be for minority, is not an intention to alienate from the majority community, but is to say, look, this is inclusive growth for those who require special support. That has always been interpreted by the BJP, which is a rank communal party, to be defined as communalism. That, according to me, is not communalism at all. Now, first of all, Mr. Raza Hussain is absolutely right. It is the supreme irony for anybody who has talked of Michael Lingdo, Hamare Paanch, Hamare Pachis, any number of other symbolic and non-symbolic issues, bringing in Pakistan and Muslims everywhere, for him to talk of this, or the puppy analogy, that's one part. But to say that it is equal to is the same as we are practicing is completely wrong, because let me put you this, Nidhi. The Congress for decades says this, Sonia Gandhi says this, that to Mulayam Singh she can say it, to the BSP she says it, to regional party she says it, that although we may not agree with you, it is our duty not to divide the communal vote, secular vote. That's not communalism. You can say it to Hindu leaders like
Mulayam Singh. Secular vote.
BJD. One second.
Yeah.
Imam Bukhari, she's saying it to a person who's leading a delegation of his community. She's not going out and saying.
So that's not asking for votes on religious lines.
I want to ask a question.
That's not asking for votes on religious lines.
One minute. Nidhi, tomorrow if there's a Jat delegation or a Yadav delegation.
There was no delegation, Abhishek.
We
it was only Imams, people. There was no Muslim delegation. There were no other leaders in that delegation.
That's all right.
There were few
That's
people, right. his family members and secretaries were there. And is Imam the symbol of secularism in this country?
Let's
is
accept
he going
that.
To unite the Hindus, Muslims, Sikhs, Christians?
No, let's accept
do you
that.
Regard him as a symbol of secularism?
No,
answer my question. Do you regard him as a symbol
that.
Of secularism
let's
in this
okay,
country?
Okay, okay, let him answer that. Yes.
Let's answer that. Let me answer that. One second. It is very different for Shahid Siddiqui to have his view, which one can respect, that Imam is not a symbol of secularism. That's very different from saying that if Sonia Gandhi meets him and says, don't divide the secular vote, she's actually practicing communalism. They're two different things. You may not agree with the Imam's politics, but you can always say that, look, we disagree with so many parties, but don't allow the secular vote to be divided. And we believe that certainly the anti-secular vote is the Modi BJP vote.
Why do you ask Imam to do that? You ask
that
secular vote
Imam
in this country should
so
not be divided.
Meters.
You go to the Hindus and say secular vote should not be divided. When do you see a Muslim and you talk of secularism, it shows that you are wearing a mask. And that is what is the anger of Muslims for the last 65 years, that you talk of secularism only when there is a Muslim crowd and nowhere else. And as if secularism is only for Muslims, they have to carry this cross of secularism.
I just said that we talk about it to Christians also, we talk about it to other minorities also, and we talk about it to caste,
why not a majority? Secularism is for majority also, for India, it's not for minorities. Secularism for this country is to be a modern state, not for minorities.
1 minute, I gave... If okay, we can I tell it to Mulayam Singh Yadav or to Mayawati, are they Hindu leaders or minority leaders?
Okay, Sudhanshu
if we can
Trivedi,
tell it to Mamata Banerjee and BJD, are they Hindu leaders or minority
okay,
leaders?
Sudhanshu Trivedi,
we say
the BJP
to everybody who we
this,
think is within the boundaries
of this. The BJP has taken this issue to the Election Commission saying that this is Sonia Gandhi asking for votes on religious lines. Now, the EC has to examine that. Many would though say, and the Congress has said that when Baba Ramdev has such a close relationship with the BJP, why is there a problem with Sonia Gandhi and the Imam Bukhari's meeting? What would you say to that?
This logic is ridiculous. Baba Ramdev is Yog Guru. And Imam Bukhari is an Imam of a mosque. Baba Ramdev is not the head of any religious sect or religious institution. How can you equate the yoga guru with any religious cleric? This is the irony of India, that those things which are part of our rich cultural heritage has been marked as communal. Actually, this event shows the pathetic condition of the Congress, because in the recently concluded assembly elections, they have seen that communalism was not an issue. The issue was price rise, corruption and good governance, and they have been routed by the public. So they have left with no other option to rake up the communal issue. And this is the persistent design of the Congress and their allies. Right from a statement of Srimati Sonia Gandhi of Zahir Ki Kheti to characterizing Narendra Modi ji as Yamraj or Hitler or whatever it is. And not only this, if they are trying to say that if BJP is saying something in indirect connotation, they try to term it as communal. I would like to say what Congress party uses to say. When Prime Minister of India on record says that Muslims should have first right over the natural resources of India, is there any scope of this way or that way interpretation? When Sonia Gandhi meets Imam and Imam says that she has asked not to divide secular vote, Sonia Gandhi should have clarified that she had not asked any support from Imam Bukhari. And not only Congress party, previously he was in Samajwadi party. 3-4 days back he was with Arvind Kejriwal in Kashi. Whether Mamata Banerjee is trying to get support of this, it shows that all anti-BJP parties are unable to face the people on the real issues of price rise, corruption and misgovernance.
Okay, but Sudhanshu Trivedi, can I ask you,
so that they can face some confidence
do you see the BJP's relationship with, say, the sadhus and sons of the VHP as a problem then? Because these are religious leaders, there are Shankaracharyas, there are other, you know, the VHP is an arm of the Sangh Parivar. So if that is not a problem, then why is Sonia Gandhi's meeting with Imam Bukhari a
Even
problem?
Even using Mandir issue by the BJP is a big problem.
Sudhanshu.
I would like to ask them, you quote a single instance when any leader of the BJP has spoken in favor of one community. I can quote you several instances of the high-ranking Congress leaders. When Home Minister of India has used the word Hindu Atankwad, which was held by Hafiz Saeed. When Mr. Rahul Gandhi, as per the WikiLeaks revelation, I'm not saying that they are totally correct, but Rahul Gandhi has not denied that he has talked to American officials that Hindu terror is more complicated. You are clearly using the word with religion towards the terrorism.
But when you have
BJP
when you have sadhus and
which
sons
can identify one community.
Sudhanshu, when you have sadhus and sons that back the BJP and openly do so, why is that not a problem and why is this a problem? Wait, it's just a very simple question. I mean, they are also religious figures who back the BJP, who openly back the BJP. That's
obviously.
Yes. So why is that not an issue?
If Sai Imam would have given this statement on its own, I would not have any problem. But when Sai Imam met Sonia Gandhi and after that he has given a statement, BJP is having serious doubts. We consider it as a political conspiracy of creating a communal tension. Sai Imam on its own has not said.
Okay,
our senior leaders
wants to come
never
in
went to religious clerics and asked their support and subsequently the statement was issued.
The problem that the BJP seems to have, Abhishek Singhvi, is the fact that the Congress president chose to have this meeting with Imam Bukhari and ask for the secular vote not to be divided in the way that she did, which they say is very different from sadhus and sons backing the BJP otherwise. Yes.
Nidhi, I find it extraordinary that a non-issue is being sought to made into an issue by a party. We have to only rewind history. How can we forget context and history? Is it possible to suggest that the BJP is not communal in its outlook when their presiding deity and guru is Guru Golwalkar Hegdewar, who has not read the Bunch of Thoughts book, who has not said certain things about certain communities in that book very specifically? Now you then try to camouflage it in various phrases. It doesn't help. Their views are clear for the last 60-70 years. And if there is any party which has consistently practiced the politics of hatred by always raising symbols, totems and slogans which have intended to inflame Hindu passions or create problems about minorities, it is this party. And this party has the gall to say that if a religious leader meets somebody and somebody says, don't divide the secular vote, we are communal. I mean, this is absolutely funny.
Abhishek,
it's amazing.
When the Congress party talks about reservations on religious lines, which it did very controversially during the UP elections, and that was struck down, you know, people see that as very cynical vote bank politics. You know, there is one, on one hand, there is the welfare of minorities, which is important. But then, you know, to talk about reservations based on religious lines, which is illegal in this country and unconstitutional, it takes it to another level.
One minute.
Yesterday, again, the Home Minister made a statement that, you know, Muslims who are in jail for a certain period of time should be released. You know, there seems to be this very sort of Muslim-centric campaign, which is seen as cynical politics.
No. Please see the context. First of all, when you proclaim a policy, it is done openly, it is not done by stealth, it is not done by innuendo, and you are prepared to take responsibility for the consequences of the policy you invoke. A policy was proposed, it has not been declared in advance to be illegal, it was subsequently by a court, it is challenged subsequent to the declaration, and the court stays it. We believe that the policy is constitutional. The matter is now pending in the apex court from Andhra Pradesh. Now, you are saying that whenever you declare an affirmative program, and for that matter we treat categories like the SCSTs, categories like even part of the backwards, and categories like the minorities, which includes both Muslims and Christians, pretty similar, because we believe that they are deprived backward categories.
Okay, that's
so it's more of the backwardness, but just happens that a large part of the backwardness is synonymous with certain communities and certain castes.